So I'm pretty sure most of you already know this, but the Patriots went ahead and cut Cam Newton to make Mac Jones the starter. And I want to start off and saying, I am not a fan of this move. I am not. To be honest, I've never really been too high on Mac Jones in general. Like, even when he was back in college, like, I personally would not have had him as a Heisman finalist. To be honest, I would have much rather have Kyle Trask or Najee Harris to fill his spot. Najee Harris obviously being the running back for the Alabama team, Kyle Trask quarterback over at Florida, but they were both having way better years, I believe, while playing a harder position. Being QB1 at Alabama is low-key the easiest job, and it doesn't really prepare the quarterbacks for the league. Like, look at Tua, he kind of struggled early. I mean, I understand that they were rookies coming in, but Tua, Jalen Hurts kind of struggled. AJ McCarron didn't really do anything. Actually, now that I think about it, it's not too many, well, recently, Alabama quarterbacks that have came out and really did anything in the league, because you have the top, the best talent in the country coming to play for you. His senior season, or junior, he came out as a junior. Mac Jones had 41 touchdowns, which looks nice, but then you kind of think about who he had. He had the Heisman winner in Devontae Smith on his team. So I've never been a fan of forcing out a young quarterback too early. Trevor Lawrence, right? The Jags went ahead and traded Gardner Minshew to the Eagles. And now, and first of all, they only got a 6th round pick. But Cam Newton, first of all, he was only on a 1-year deal, 1-year $14 million deal, which is mostly incentivized. Like, he was only guaranteed $3.5 million with including his signing bonus. So really, out of his contract, he was really only guaranteed $1.5 million. And that's a veteran quarterback who understands like how to play. He made it to the Super Bowl before. I mean, I know he's always had like little problems with his throwing and all of that, but you're not even, if you know that Mac Jones is your future guy, he's your franchise guy, they should have kept Cam Newton and decided, like, hey, we're gonna let Cam start. The same thing with the Bears are doing with Andy Dalton right now. We're gonna let Cam start first. Well, Andy Dalton probably only gonna play one game because they promised him that, and everybody wanted Justin Fields. And personally, I think Justin Fields is better. But I always think when a rookie quarterback comes, they should keep the guy, keep the vet that's there, especially if it's a vet who has proven himself, and let him play maybe like 3 to 4 weeks as a backup so they understand. Up to 6, no more than 6 games, but as a backup so they understand, like, hey, this is a pro, this is how we do it, all of that, yada yada yada. You keep that veteran leadership, even if you don't intend on staying with the vet. On top of that, they haven't really made any changes on their offensive line. They got Trent Brown from the Raiders, and it's pretty decent, but their offensive line is pretty young. The average age is about 26, which it's not too bad, but you definitely want that experience. They're young. So personally, I think Bill Belichick made the wrong move, and they definitely should have kept Cam Newton. Even if you were only gonna play him for a couple weeks, maybe Mac Jones is the guy. Slow and mobile. White pocket passing. Bill Belichick has did this before, and he turned out to be the greatest quarterback of all time. So I'm not saying he can be Tom Brady, but this isn't uncharted territory for Bill Belichick. So he's the NFL coach who's clearly proven himself. I'm just getting into this like video thing. So pretty sure he knows more than me, but hey, Bill, I doubt you're watching this. If you're watching this, you made the wrong decision. Should have kept Cam. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I just wanted to go ahead and talk about that because I'm a big Cam Newton fan. Plus, this is kind of something that's been going on throughout preseason. I didn't watch too much preseason, personally. What I did see, Cam wasn't playing too bad. You know, he had the same little accuracy problems, but he was going against like first teams and he was being solid. I think it was the second game. I forgot who they played. I believe it was the Giants. He went 8 for 9 and he had a touchdown. So he can still play. I know the Cowboys are apparently interested in him. He'll definitely be a backup. We don't really don't know what's going on with Dak. He's been limited in mini camp. He was limited in preseason. So, and they pay him all that money, so they can't throw him out too early and mess him up. So I wouldn't be surprised if we do see Cam Newton to the Cowboys. I hope this isn't the end of Cam Newton's run as an NFL quarterback, because he's always been one of my favorite. But if it is, shout out that boy, Cam.